Hello, hello, my lovely. Welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to go through this big box because this is all the stuff that I bought in May and June last year. And I'm going to tell you if this haul was worth it, yes or no. I am going to sort of rank them. I am not going to really have numbers up because I have like 1,000 palettes in here. But I'm going to show you my least favorite up to my most favorite from this haul I did. I want to start this series because I think it's fun to see what makeup you're actually using a year later. Because, you know, in a few months I forget stuff. I don't come around to using everything but a year. Girl, if you get some makeup, you better have been using it within that year. Am I right? Am I right? Okay, so I am going to get everything out and then we are going to get started. And if this is your first time here, then hi, welcome. My name is Anneke Dis, and on my channel, I want to inspire you to use a little bit of color every day. I create fun, colorful looks, but I try to keep them a little bit more wearable so you can actually wear them every day to work, to your in-laws, going out with friends, because we can a little bit more right now, thank God. So that is what I do here on my channel. I mainly use high-end and indie brands. So if that is something that sounds very interesting to you, if that is right up your alley, then please consider subscribing. I upload 2 times a week, or at least I try. I have a new puppy, but I try to upload at least 2 times a week. So there's always something fun to watch. And I am going to dive into the makeup that is in front of me. I'm going to start off, and this is not necessarily my least favorite. It's just something I haven't used. This is the number 4. It's a liquid eyeshadow from 5050 Makeup. It's like in a bronzy shade. It's, I think, really nice. I've heard great things about their liquid shadow, so that is why I wanted to get it. But I haven't used it yet. And that is really why I'm doing this series, because I feel I should be wearing the makeup. So this is also a way to keep myself a little bit more accountable for actually using what I got, or buy less. That is also an option, you know. Next up is this the Naked Honey from Urban Decay palette. I like it. It's just not really my total favorite formula. I noticed that I got this, you know, the thing. When I saw this on a Will I Buy It video I did, I was like, I want to have that. Because this, to me, is honey. It's like honey colors. It's not bees, but it's honey. So I was like, I really like it. I like the fact that the browns are a little bit more murky. You have that greenish yellow over here. Stunning. Somehow, I don't reach for this. So it's maybe too monochromatic. I don't know why I don't reach for this, and maybe I should do that a little bit more. It's not that I necessarily think that the formula is bad by any means, just a little bit boring. Then I have the Hasina 2 palette. This is a blush stripe palette. Blush stripe shut down, then she started Mayali Beauty, and she also shut down a Mayali Beauty already. I'm really bummed about that because I really love the palette she came out with. But this is the Hasina 2. It's a stunning palette. I really like it. The formula is good. I wouldn't say great. It is not great for me. It's good. I think it's good. I really like it. I think these colors are really stunning. The only reason why I put it a little bit more down here is because I feel like this is a color story that is very bold and very overwhelming. So for me, this is really a companion palette. It's not a like full palette in itself. I usually don't really mind that, but if I have to rank it, then I think, you know, it could do with some lighter shades as well. But it is a stunning palette. It's a stunning formula, but you can't get it anymore. So that is also why it's a little bit lower down. Ooh, then I have another palette I have been neglecting to use, and that is the Juvia's Place The Festival palette. I did a really big haul for Juvia's Place. This is a one I haven't used yet, so that is why I'm putting it here, because I know it will be good. I just haven't used it yet, so I can't really put it higher than this, basically. But I think it will be better than the ones I've shown you before. Then I have the Nubian 3 Coral palette from Juvia's Place. I really do like this palette. It's just that I thought it would be a little bit more interesting than it really is. Somehow, it is, even though you have the grays with the coral, it doesn't speak to me. And I thought it would be, but it isn't really doing that. The formula is really nice. The quality is good. It's not nothing like that. It's just that it's not, I don't get inspired by this. And I was a little bit like, confused because I thought this is something that would really challenge me, you know, but I don't think it's colorful enough or something. I don't know. Then I have another product from Juvia's Place. I did a big haul, I think in June or May, I don't really remember, but I got this concealer. It's in the shade 19. The shade is really nice. It's a tad light, but I think that can be very good. It can be very helpful to have something really light. It's just that the formula is so thick. I am 38, so my under eyes are a little bit crepey, a little bit foldy and stuff like that. So this doesn't really work that well for me. So yeah, I like it, but I like to use it to mix it with foundations that are a little bit too dark or a little bit too yellow. Then I like to use this, but not necessarily use it as a concealer. So it's not a bad concealer by any means. It's just way too heavy for me. And that is why I'm putting it here. Then next up, I have this palette from 5050 Makeup. This is the summer palette. And this is a stunner of a palette. It is so cute. The color story is so much fun. It's the same with the Hasina one. It's just very bold, very bright, very much a companion palette to me. So I really love this. I love the color story. It's just that I need something to, you know, a white maybe to lighten everything up. It's just not a complete palette for me. It's not a complete color story for me. As I said, I don't even mind that much. But if I'm ranking, I have to put this a little lower. But it is a stunning palette. This is a stunning shade, and especially this blue. Chef's kiss, truly. It is stunning. It is cute. It's stunning. I love 5050 Makeup, and yeah, love it. Then a palette maybe people are going to be a little bit like, girl, what you saying? That is this one. It's a Divine Rose number 2, so it's the Sublime 8 palette. Okay, I have done I think 2 videos on this palette. I like it. It's a nice palette. The formula is also really nice. It's just way too expensive for what it is. I'm sorry, I'm throwing that out there. I am a boozy bitch, but I don't like to pay too much money for something that is not worth it, basically. I think Pat McGrath is a very beautiful brand. I'm wearing the foundation right now. I really love it. It is really stunning. But when it comes to the eyeshadows, I'm a little bit like, does it need to be that expensive? Does it now? Does it? I don't think so. I don't even like all the shades. I don't really like this shade. It doesn't perform really well. And I don't like the duochrome because I'm wearing a duochrome by or a multichrome by Davina today. And if you are a little bit spoiled, if you have Cleonat, if you have Davina, if you have Terramoon, then you don't need a multichrome from Pat McGrath. It's basically what it is. So this is ranked not like on the bottom, but in the medium tier. I'm glad I got it. It's just not that special, basically. So yeah, sue me. Okay, now it is getting a little bit harder because I'm going into products I really, really like. And I'm going to start off with the 5050 Makeup. And this is one of a few I got. This is a loose pigment and it is a multichrome. Look at this shade. It is so stunning. It is just shade number 34, as you can see. It's like a very beautiful red with a gold and right up my alley. So I really like their loose pigments. It's like multichrome pigments. They are really, really stunning. I have like 5, I believe. I really like them. And then I am going over to the Pixie by Petra. This is such an old one. This is the Glowy Gossamer Duo, and this is in Subtle Sunrise. And this is one I have been eyeing forever because Tati Westbrook, she's back, by the way. And I must say, I'm really happy. She's back and she's always saying that this is such a stunning highlighter palette. And it is. It's just a highlighter palette. It's a little bit boring. It's a little bit basic, but it does what it needs to do. It's just not as interesting as the rest I'm going to show you. So that is why it's here. But it's a great product. Then in the same category, I got this NARS Overlast palette. This is a beautiful palette. I've been using this in my project pen. I wanted to use 1/4 gram or 1/2 gram, something like that. But I want to get some use out of it. It is beautiful. It is stunning. Especially the blushes are really beautiful. The highlighters are... maybe I can show you. Doesn't this look like there's hard pen on them? And you can see those little like scratches in them. Because I have been trying to... go at them with like a spoolie to make sure that I got some pigment loose. But they're just really subtle. A little bit too subtle for me. And I really love a subtle highlighter, but it's a little bit too subtle. So that is why I'm putting it here and not a little bit higher up. Because if it was only the blushes, this would be top three easily. But because of these like very highlighters, I'm putting it here. Next up is the Dip Brow. This is a pomade dip brow. I believe it's in the shade Taupe from Anastasia Beverly Hills. It's a mini. It's a like brow gel type of deal, but with pigment. I love it. It is really nice. I have quite okay brows, so I don't need to really draw them in a lot. So I can get away with just using something like this. And I love this. I love this. I really like that it is pigmented, but not too much. It is really basically my the tone of my hairs, or the for my eyebrow hairs. How do I say that? Eyebrow hairs? That sounds weird. It sounds a little bit dirty even. But it is the same shade, so it really fits like my complexion. I love this product. It's a very beautiful product. It's just that it's just an eyebrow gel. So that is why I'm putting it here and not a little bit higher up. But I love this. Totally recommend. Then the next palette is by VE Cosmetics, or V Cosmetics. And it's the Vixen palette. I got this palette because Nikki Raven was raving. I love saying that. Nikki Raven was raving about this palette. So I got it. And she wasn't kidding. It is a very, very beautiful palette. It is so stunning. It has everything. Everything. It has the light. It has the dark. It has the yellows. It has the pinks. It has the oranges and the reds. It is so beautiful. I love, love, love this palette. And you would say that it's like only for like fall, but it's also really good for summer because it has some very vibrant colors over here. So you can totally make a summer look out of this as well. So it is really versatile as well. I love this one. Then I got these six from Divina Cosmetics. I think these are in that like Exploders collection. I have to check. I'll check and then I'll put it somewhere here. I think these are either the Candy Cakes or the Exploders. One out of two. But I also got the Candy Cakes collection or the Exploders. It's one out of two. I don't remember. These are really light. These are like a pastel topper shade. Very stunning. Love how they perform. Divina is... I love Divina. I'm wearing their Aurora Flare Multichrome today. And I think this is Borealis. I think so. And this is, I think, the Candy Cakes. I think. These have a little bit more base to them. So they have a little bit more color to them. And they are stunning on the eyes. I will swatch this green one for you. Need I say more? It is so beautiful. I love Divina. So these are up here. And then I have two palettes from Juvia's Place. I have the Nomad. This one. This is a palette I have been eyeing forever until I bought this. Somehow I just didn't get around to it. Sometimes you have a palette and you're like, oh, I still want to get that. And you never do. Somehow. And it always... You know, it always comes back. It's always in the back of your mind. And this is one like that for me. And I'm so happy I finally got it. This is a color story that is right up my alley with the yellows, the greens, the murkiness. I love it. And in that same category, because I can't really choose between the two, is the Tribe palette. It's also green. It's just a really vibrant. It's also from Juvia's Place. This is beautiful. I don't really know what is up with this palette when it comes to if it's still available, yes or no, because I hear a lot of stories about it. One says it isn't, the other says it will come back. I don't know. If you can get a hold of it, if you like these type of colors, it is a stunning palette. It is fun. It is cheap. The quality is great. So this is, you can go wrong, really. Okay, and then we are getting into my top three. And when I was ranking them, I was like, okay, I rank them basically as how often I will use a product. So that is why the Divina Cosmetics were a little bit lower than the two palettes from Juvia's Place. Because I would reach for this a little bit sooner than I would reach for these. Because I have to create a whole look just to use one or two of these shades. That is how I rank this. So having said that, on number three, I got my Wayne Goss Camellia lipstick. It is such a beautiful lipstick. It is very pale looking, but what I've learned is if you put some nice, like, what did I put underneath? If you put a beautiful, any type of beautiful lip liner underneath this one, it will transform. It is such a versatile lipstick because of that. If you have it just like this, it is a little bit like, I can wear it like this It is not like concealer lips type of, you know, situation. But it's not extremely flattering, in my opinion. But if you use something like this, like a coral lip liner, and then you put it over, it totally transforms. And I also like to use it with like something darker, like this one. This is the Absolutely It from MAC Cosmetics. And you wouldn't put these together necessarily very quickly, but if you do, it gives a stunning effect. And the funny thing is, it is because I think that this formula is so soft, you get just a beautiful shade out of it. I'm trying to show you. You see what I mean? If you blend them together, it really transforms. The tops, you know, you see what I mean? You can go a lot of ways with this beautiful little lipstick. I really love this shade. And I really love the formula. I also have Carnation, I believe, but I didn't haul it around this time. Then on number two, I have the number 18 brush from Wayne Goss. This is the second one I put an order in for the lipstick and I think for a lip liner. No, I got the lip liner before that. I put in the order for the lipstick and also got this number 18 brush. Yes, I only ordered two things and I let it ship from the Americas to me. I'm realizing how much of a thing that is. But okay, I love the number 18 brush from Wayne Goss. It's one of my favorite blending brushes. This is the type of brush I always start my looks off because you get like that medium shade, you put it on your outer corner and then you blend it in. You can also use, because you saw it like go in, it's the same as the number one brush or the 217S brush from MAC or the number one from Reffer. It's just that the number one from Reffer is really stiff. The 217S from MAC is a little less stiff, but this one is not stiff at all. It's so loose, so it's I love this one because sometimes you don't have to go in with a lot of pigment. You just want to tap it in and just blend it out. And this one really beautifully does this. So if I'm honest, I reach for this one the most over the Reffer and the MAC. I love this brush. So I have two, but I could have five basically. And then for the number one spot from this haul is the Ofra collab with Samantha March. I got all of the products. This is the highlighter. This is the Start Inspired highlighter. Beautiful. It's very white and it's very light, so you can't really see it, but it's a stunning highlighter. I also got the blush. This is the Chick Lip blush. It's loose, so that's a bit annoying, but it is a beautiful blush. You have like a matte side and a shimmery side. Love it, especially like the tones are working so well with my skin, tone or my complexion, however you want to call it. And this is the same with the River Bronzer Duo. Also on one side you have like that shiny side and you have a matte side. I love it. They blend beautifully. They are very pigmented, so you have to go in very light-handed, but they are stunning. Especially this bronzer, you would say that this is very orange. It isn't. I have been reaching for this collection so much. I think the most out of all the products I have in front of me. So that is why it's on the number one spot. Okay, ladies, thank you so much. I hope this video was a little bit helpful, or at least a little bit more fun to see what was going on a year ago. Well, not a whole lot except for Rona, but still. Yeah, no. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you liked what you saw. If you did, then please give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already, because I would love to see you in my next one. Bye.